Cowboys, CC, this offseason, between Dak and Zeke coming back, between Dez and Witten not being there, are the Dallas Cowboys set up for Dak to be a top-tier quarterback with everything they have and the pieces they have in place right now?
Well, I don't know. That's one of the questions going into the season. Can they answer that? You know, is Dak an elite quarterback? And or have the Dallas Cowboys put in a position to be an elite quarterback? And if he's going to be an elite quarterback, first thing you have to do is look at Dallas, what style they're going to play. Offensive line, they got three Pro Bowlers on the offensive line. They got one of the top two or three running backs in the NFL. So it's going to be, offense going to be dictated on what they do. So they're going to be a running dominant team. What other quarterbacks have started their career on either running-dominated teams or on teams that were defensive-oriented, teams that the quarterbacks that have won the Super Bowl? Of recent history, Russell Wilson. Before that, Joe Flacco. And before that, Ben Roethlisberger. All these quarterbacks, especially Ben and Russell, took over defensive-oriented teams when they were very, very young. And that's just like taking over a team that has a dominant running game.
Would you add maybe to that list Tom Brady? When the original iteration,
they weren't defensive dominant. Okay. I would say they were just a good team.
All right.
I would say in the skill sets of those other two players, I'm going to try to tell a story between the two of them. And I just believe it's very, very important that how do you change that ID from the team that you took over? Ben, when he took over, they were defensive oriented, went to the Super Bowl, managed the game. All right. After that, what'd they do? They got Ben some weapons around them. They started throwing the ball a little more, start trusting them. Then they became prolific in the passing game. Russell Wilson, he's very, very similar to Dak. You know, not a high draft pick. Took over because either I'm better or a guy's injured. Now, Seattle had a defensive-dominated team and Marshawn Lynch. Got him a couple wide receivers, unheralded. They developed in where they could throw the ball at a high, high rate. Now, Dak, what's he going to do? I don't believe the defense is going to become dominant. Did Dallas get him the type of weapons around him that I believe help him become one of the most prolific offensive throwing teams? No, I don't see that. So if he is not careful, he's going to end up like Joe Flacco. Because Joe Flacco took over. They haven't changed their ID.
Right.
But maybe they tried and realized they couldn't. Didn't Baltimore at least try? I mean, they just saw he wasn't
able to do it. Baltimore has never put the necessary resources behind Joe Flacco to help him become an elite passer. Now, people might say, well, Joe Flacco, you know, he hasn't helped Baltimore. But Baltimore has been a defensive-oriented team since Ray Lewis has retired. They're still trying to figure out what their identity is going to be.
Yeah, but Flacco, I mean, the best weapon they gave him post-Super Bowl is Steve Smith.
Yes.
At the later portion of his career. Like, I mean, so that's I think, the point is that they didn't, those other teams brought in, Seattle brings in Jimmy Graham, and they developed the young wide receivers. Pittsburgh, we know, they spent high draft pick on Mike Wallace. They also develop Antonio Brown. Like, they give him the weapons. So you're saying Dallas
right now, that's best receiver is the guy don't want to be known as an athlete, want to be known as a rapper, and Cole Beasley. I mean, like, that to me is not setting you up to play great. All right. They need a number one receiver. They don't have one on their roster. And teams, as we saw last year, put more and more people committed to the line of scrimmage. They slow down Zeke. And then what do? Now the rest of the pressure is on Dak, and we haven't seen him grow. And that's the question that he's going to have to answer this season.
I got a question for you here. And if you are a great quarterback, I'm not saying Dak is, but if you are a great quarterback, rank these for me in order of importance. A great offensive line, a great running back, a great wide receiving core. If you're a great quarterback, your wish list, number one would be what?
A great offensive line.
Number two would be what?
In this new NFL, it's hard to say with a running back because there's so many guys that seem to do it by committee. I would say, you know, if he's going to be a special Hall of Fame back, I would say the running back compared to the wide receiver.
Okay, so here's this is exactly what I thought you'd say. If you're a great quarterback, the weapons around you are less important than, are you protected? And does the other team have to respect the running
game? Give yourself a chance to succeed.
Right. Do you have a chance to succeed? And is the other team's game plan going into the week only about stopping the passing attack, or do they also have to worry about stopping the running game, right?
So you don't know if your quarterback is a great quarterback.
Well, so that's the, walked me right into it, Jenna. If you were, if you're already a Pro Bowl quarterback, if Drew Brees stepped into the Cowboys, I think Aaron Rodgers, Tom, any of the great guys, they'd be like, this is awesome. I'm never getting hit. My running back's great. I'll make the wide receivers spectacular. Right. But if you're not yet a great quarterback, you might change that order of importance. You might say, man, I'd really like some wide receivers that I know can go up and get the ball for me. Mm-hmm. Someone that I know is going to win 50-50 balls. Someone that I know that if I throw a quick slant to, he can maybe break it open and make those chunk plays. And that's what Dak doesn't have. So in order for the Cowboys' philosophy to make it look like they've got a great offense, Dak then has to be that first group of quarter, that first group, because the wide receivers aren't going to do it for him.
And if Dak is saying, I want to be the greatest quarterback ever, the Dallas franchise have to realize the two greatest quarterbacks they ever had, the great Roger Staubach and Troy Aikman, look at the players they have around them.
Of course.
Not only did Roger have the legendary coach, he had the innovation of the coach, the new offensive thing, first team to go in motion with the shifts and everything, but in the backfield, wide receiver, like Pro Bowl players at that. Troy Aikman, he's part of the triplets. Michael Irvin, yeah. Emmitt, Hall of Famers. Hall of Fame offensive linemen. Pro Bowl offensive linemen, three of the five. So they had the supporting cast, which supported the quarterback, that they could eventually get to that greatness that the both of them reached.
So getting back to what you said, rank what you think that Dak Prescott has. So where, as far as offensive line, his running back, his running game, and his wide receivers,
they have
a running game.
I think they have one of the five best offensive lines in football, and when healthy, arguably one of the two best. I think they have, when healthy or when on the field, one of the two best running backs in football. And I think they don't have one of the 22 best wide receiving corps in football.
Okay.
I think that's where they're at right now.
So if you have two of the three, isn't that sort of the Cowboys setting you up in some capacity to be successful?
I think it's setting the team up potentially to be successful, but not necessarily Dak for the progression that we thought he would have.
In the NFL, you move the ball by the running game, but you score the football by the passing game. And right now, they're not scoring enough touchdowns to be able to offset their defense.
All right, cool. Take a break. Coming up.